Good evening. First tonight, 77,000 preps were among more than 1 million Victorian children heading back to school today under a new rapid testing regime. Most will face a nasal swab twice a week in an effort to head off the disruption that's marked the past 2 years of education. Still, though, some parents are refusing to send their young people to school until safety improves.
Not yet back in the classroom. And already doing tests.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Morning school prep looks a little different in 2022. Not that these young people mind.
It tickles my nose a little bit.
Just as long as it means no more online lessons.
It'll be a change, that's for sure, with 3 kids, but we'll cope with it. We want them to go back to school.
The government declaring the era of remote learning over as 1 million children return to school.
We made a commitment that we'd get students back to school day one, term one, and that's exactly what is happening.
It's not quite normal yet. Masks are mandatory in classrooms, many of which are now fitted with air purifiers, and it's recommended students take 2 rapid tests a week. A complicated setup, but the stars of the show understand why.
It's so that we can go to school without infecting others with COVID.
So I can go back to school and meet my friends.
By the end of the day, 6 million testing kits will be delivered to schools around the state. At Mount View Primary, they were handed out to parents during the morning drop-off.
They're hard to find, yes. This is the best way, I think, for school kids.
Toorak College, though, was yet to receive its shipment.
We have received some of our rats from the state government. I'm assured that there's a few more on a truck to it.
Even though safety measures are in place, a spike in cases is anticipated.
The Doherty modelling has shown that there will be some increase. They've put high, central and low predictions. So far, of course, what we've seen across the country has been lower.
As a result, some parents are going to keep their children at home until they've received 2 doses of the vaccine.
I just think, you know, being a logical thinker, it's a couple of weeks to wait to have that extra 20% of protection.
Or until ventilation is improved.
The school's doing everything that they can to get the ventilation to what it needs to be to protect all the kids. Some of the classrooms are there, a few of them are not.
Patrick Murrell for 10 News First.